This is Mark with Mountain Elegance, and I'm just going to show how you attach the moss to these foam boards. And it's pretty easy, and we just kind of laid the design out here on this, and that's what you can do. And typically we take a lot of this as fern moss, and it's like, I call it sheet moss or fern moss, and it can fill in the low spots. Like if you want a lot of low areas and give it texture, you put the low pieces in here to fill in. Once you get your bunches, it's kind of like that. But all the moss attaches with these greening pins. And if you've got, this is actually an inch and a half foam board, but the do-it-yourself kits, it's got frames on them, has an inch foam board. So when you put the greening pin in, on the 1-inch ones, you have to push it in an angle or you're gonna hit the backing board in the back. But these are thicker, so these kind of push straight down like that. And then you just kind of bunch it up to hide the greening pin. And you can do a pull test. Once you get several in, you can pull it and see if it needs more greening pins. And they usually provide plenty in there. Like the mound moss, you can't hardly put a greening pin in that, so you're gonna have to use your glue gun to fill in those areas. So you just put glue on the back of the moss and down in here both, and just kind of press it in and hold it down for just a minute. But the rest of the moss, you're just going to put in. If you want to bunch it up and make like texture, you could just put a greening pin in like that, kind of bunch it up, do one on this side, and that kind of gives more added outgoing texture to the pieces. But you kind of see, it goes real quick. You kind of lay out your design, and then you can just put the greening pins when you're through. The ones that's got frames on them, you don't have to worry about the edges. These are the thicker ones for like the living edge ones, but the frame ones only goes up to the side, so you don't have to worry about that on the frame ones. It's pretty simple, and you just go right on around, do a pull test, make sure you got everything firms up good. But again, on the 1-inch boards that's got the frame, you'd have to go in a real good angle, 45 or more, to make sure you're not hitting the backing board. These you don't have to worry about because they're thicker. And that's pretty much it. Got any questions, just contact us by Messenger. Thanks.